Father had one son. He loved him very much. Each afternoon, he would pick him up from school without fail. One day, there was a massive earthquake in this poor village, and the school had collapsed on all the students. The villagers knew it was the end for those kids, but the father did not stop removing the rubble. He didn't eat. He didn't sleep. He didn't take one break. And after 36 straight hours, with bloodied hands and scarred bones, he was able to see a small opening in the rubble where his son was sitting below with one third of his class. The boy then said to his friends, "I told you my father would come." The love of a father is powerful. Our God loves us 1,000,000 times more than the man loved his boy. Our God cares for us beyond measure and wants us to be truly happy. He sent his only son to die for us so that we may be united with him forever. With God, all things are possible. Trust in the Lord with all your heart. Lean not on your own understanding. In all your ways, acknowledge him, and he will guide your path. God is the good shepherd who protects his flock. He gives us strength. He is our rock. He is the potter. We are the clay. He is our bread for every day. God is the fire refining the gold. It is his spirit that helps us be bold. We must be fierce, be strong, and be brave. Amidst a culture that wants us to be enslaved to our passions and appetites, we must fight. We were made for battle, built for combat. We were made for greatness, nothing short of that. The battle is real, even though the devil wants us to think otherwise. He wants us to go with the flow and believe his lies. We might not get shot at, killed, or nailed to a cross, but we will get spit at, rejected, and suffer loss. But it is the dead fish that float with the current. The living fish fight the flow and go upstream, resisting and persisting by every means. It is time to rise up and fight with one accord. Christ didn't come for peace, but with the sword. He is the Lord. He gives his word. He will be with us. He has overcome the world. We can do all things through Christ, the resurrection and the life. Cast all your cares on him, for he cares for you. Pick up your cross daily and follow him too. Work out your salvation in fear and trembling. The devil is prowling, looking to devour. Fight the good fight at every hour. We must cast off sin, be born again, run the race to win, trusting in him. Life is a battleship, not a cruise ship. Let iron sharpen you, put on the full armor of God. Do all things for the glory of God. Seek first his kingdom. Strive to enter through the narrow gate. It is never too late. Be not afraid, don't be ashamed. Our hope does not disappoint. Give without counting the cost. Fight and don't heed the wound. Toil, seek no rest. Always give your absolute best. Labor and don't seek reward. Do the will of the Lord. Serve him as he deserves. Be ferocious. Be all in. There are no half saints. God has made saints out of far worse people than you. God has made saints out of great sinners, but he's never made a saint out of a wimp. Have no fear. Have confidence. He has overcome. He has already won. Be a warrior. Be a beast. Be a disciple. Be a beast for Christ.